Hello, I'm Robin Whalley. Welcome to this final video in my latest mini-series where we looked at the editing of this image. In the previous video, we made the conversion from colour to black and white using NIC Silver Effects Pro. In this video, I'm going to add some finishing touches to the image to soften it and to emphasise and de-emphasise areas of the image, and I'm going to do all this in Affinity Photo. The first thing I want to do is look at dodging and burning, and we'll use this to highlight areas of the millstone and also de-emphasize surrounding areas of foliage. To do the dodging and burning, I'm going to start by duplicating the silver effects layer that I created in the previous video. And I'm going to rename that Dodge and Burn. Now there's lots of ways you can do dodging and burning using tools in Affinity. In this video, I'm going to look at dodging and burning with the Dodge and Burn tools that you find over on the left side of the interface. And I'm going to start with the dodging brush. Now when you're dodging and burning, what you're doing is you're lightening or darkening areas of the image. And the thing to keep in mind is that when you highlight an area, you make it more obvious to the viewer, whereas if you darken it, you tend to de-emphasize the attention from that area. Now when we dodge and burn, dodging will lighten an area, whereas burning will darken it. If you struggle to remember the two, just think of the term burning in detail, and that means darkening light areas to make them more obvious. So burning in detail tells you to darken it, so burning darkens the image, whereas dodging will lighten it. Now I'm going to start with dodging, and up in the context sensitive toolbar, I've got the tonal range set to midtones. So I'm going to be targeting the mid-tone areas in this image with the lightening effect from dodging. And I'm going to start by lightening the area of these millstones. Now the other thing I suppose I should say is that I've got the opacity set only at about 14. I'll push that up to 20. I wouldn't normally work at such a high opacity, but it will help you see what I'm doing. And I've got the hardness set at 0. And the reason I'm setting the hardness at 0 is I'm actually dodging quite a large area at once. And when you're dodging large areas, it tends to help with the blending of those areas. Now I'm just lightening up some of the foliage that surrounds the rocks. And if I turn off the layer, you can see the difference that we've created. Now I'm going to switch to the other tool, the burn tool. And again, I'm going to still work on the midtones, and I'm just going to harden up the detail or the edges of the brush slightly, something to around 30%. And I'm also going to use a much smaller brush. And what I'm doing this time is I'm just going to highlight around the edge of the millstone. And I'm trying to do this in a way that's not so obvious, but it will help to emphasize the difference between the millstone and its surrounding areas by creating this contrasty edge to it. And I'll do the same around this one. I'm just creating this edge between the two, and I'm going to actually work a little bit smaller in terms of the brush here. And by emphasizing the edges, it just makes the shapes stand out a little bit more, so you're just drawing around it. And it is a little bit of a repetitive task, but it's worth the effort. And I also want to just darken down the mosses that are on the stone here. So I'm working with detail. Don't be afraid to go to smaller brushes to work on just areas of detail to make them stand out that little bit more. Now I also want to darken down the millstones in the distance here. And also darken down that rock there just a little bit more. I'm now going to enlarge the brush quite a bit. And I'm going to go back to a zero hardness just so I can darken down that area just very slightly around the edge of the frame. And then again, down into this area, I'll darken it a little bit more. And into the corners here. And that creates the look we want. So if you look at the original and now look at the adjusted area, you can see that the millstones are more obvious and the foliage is a little bit lighter in these areas. Now I'm just going to go back to the dodge brush, and this time I'm just going to go for the highlights, and I'm just going to target the highlights in these areas, and you can see them immediately getting that much brighter. Now I've probably overdone that, so one of the things that I want to show you is this tool here, this little cogged tool. So I've got the dodge and burn layer selected, I click the blend ranges as it's known, and now I can actually control where the blending takes place. So over here I've got the adjustment which I can actually take down here, and as I do that you'll see the highlights that I've just created stop blending. So I can actually choose whether or not to include a lot of that dodging there that I've created, and you can add other adjustments to this. So the left side of it relates to the darkest areas, whereas the light areas are over on the right. And just by using those, I can actually control the adjustments that I've just created in the highlights. So I'm happy with that. And you can see the difference there. And of course, if I find that too strong, I can reduce the opacity of the layers very slightly. And that now looks about right for the conversion that I wanted to take place. What I'm going to do now is create a new stamp layer. So this is a layer that combines all the other layers together into one new layer. And the way I'm doing that is by holding down the Shift, Option, Command and E keys on my keyboard. So if you're using a Windows PC, that's Shift, Alt, Control and E. And now we've got our new layer. So if I just turn all the other layers off, you can see that new layer there. If I turn on the two layers, the silver effects and background layer, and I turn that off, you can see again it shows the effect of the dodging and burning. The next thing I want to do is to create my softening effect that I want to create for this image, because the image at the moment is just a little bit too harsh. So I'll select the layer that I've just created, and I'm going to do this as I often do using frequency separation. And in the frequency separation dialog, I'm just going to create a soft effect where I can hardly see the detail in the image, but it's very, very blurred. So something around, in this case, the 24 pixels. I'll just apply that. Now that's created two layers from the one layer that I had. One of them's called the low frequency. If I turn off the high frequency, you'll see that's the blurring effect. The high frequency layer, if I turn off the low frequency, that's a contrast adjustment that sharpens up the image. If I put the two into a single folder, I can turn it off and on, and you'll see there's no difference at the moment. Now the way I create the blurring effect is I'll go to the high frequency layer, and then I'll reduce the opacity of that layer, and it just softens up the image and gives it that nice dreamy effect. Now the other thing I try to do is I'll duplicate the low frequency layer. So I'll just Command and J on my keyboard. And then I'll reduce the opacity of that down to something like 25%, and then change its blending mode to soft light. And that creates quite a nice effect on that layer. So there's the original, which is quite harsh. And there's the softened one that's got this nice glowing effect to it. Now again, if you wanted to hide the effect from certain parts of the image, you could apply a layer mask to this, or you could use this blending range. So by doing the adjustment down to zero here for the input value, I'm affecting the blacks in the image, and that allows me to control where the blending actually takes place. So what I've done here is I've created something where the blurring doesn't take place in dark areas, or it only takes place to a small degree. And then I increase it quite dramatically through the shadows, midtones, and then onto the highlights where it's at the maximum level. That's created the finished image. I'm Robin Whalley, you've been watching Lenscraft. I'll see you next time for another video.